Rampage games are a guilty pleasure of mine. They always have controls and graphics that are a bit off, but at the same time, the completely brainless yet fun gameplay is good in short bursts. Like, you could sit down and play a Rampage game and have genuine fun for maybe 30-minute snippets every few months or so. The only way Rampage games would have a better concept is if instead of giant monsters, it was a giant mutated Jean-Claude Van Damme, and he would just spinning head kick buildings and then smash people with his crotch as he did splits on the street. But there's really very little fun to have in this Rampage game, Rampage Through Time. There are some good things. For example, there is a load of different monsters and just a ton of different cities to destroy. I mean, literally any fictional or real place in the history of human civilization you can think of is probably in this game. Like Atlantis, yep, it's there. Neo-Tokyo, yeah, it's there. Greece, it's there. And for the most part, all the cities look different. They all have different armies, different enemies to destroy, and different people to eat. Aesthetically, the game is very rich, but unfortunately, the gameplay and strategy in every single city level is completely identical. It's like boxing the same guy over and over, but he just puts on a different mask for every fight. In the default controller scheme, the X button punches, and the square button kicks. It doesn't make any sense because kicks are a lower attack. I mean, in any decent fighting game, X would be a kick and square would be a punch because your arms are just higher on your body than your legs. It's just more intuitive that way, but whatever, it's a minor complaint. This game starts off with the longest and most annoying cutscene I have ever seen. They try to make it like funny, like this bumbling news agency that's reporting on these monsters that have escaped through a time machine and now are causing havoc all throughout time. But it's not funny, and it's overly long. I mean, I didn't count it, but it feels like this little news report took about 8 minutes. And the jokes are like, hey, we're on camera, come on, stop clearing out your nose. And then this special report thing is flashing in front of the guy, and he can't report because it's still in his face, so he has to kind of kneel under it and go, hey, there's a special report going on. And I swear these little bits last for about 10 times longer than they should. Oh, something fell on him! Ha 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 ha! I'm surprised a jive-talking Autobot didn't come on screen and fart into the news anchor's face. They should have done a news report on Medea tackling a would-be purse snatcher. Oh, he picked the wrong sassy granny, didn't he? In every game mode, you have to have two NPCs running along with you smashing up the city. They're not really helping you, in fact, they're your enemies. When the three enemies are in the same general vicinity, it's just a clusterfuck. You don't know what's going on, especially when there's other things on the screen. And sometimes when the three of you are in the same space, the game just glitches out and you get stuck. No excuse for getting stuck in a Rampage game, especially since the way to get out of any situation should just be to smash your way out. This is not a good Rampage game because it's more frustrating than fun. And the worst part in this game is these little mini games. Oh my god, Becky, look at these mini games. They control like utter shit and they're impossible. You literally spend more time dying in these minigames than playing. Check out this asteroid clone, for example. You have to shoot down the asteroids, but then there's two other spaceships flying around trying to shoot you. You're smashing into the asteroids, the controls are just abysmal, and then there's two other spaceships shooting you. I mean, the second you respawn, you're either gonna get shot down by an NPC or an asteroid will fly right into you. The minigames are a complete pain in the ass, and the actual rampaging gameplay isn't fun because there's glitches and there's two other enemies just in your way, destroying almost any amount of fun you would have smashing the buildings. Rampage Through Time gets an official Stan Birdman rating of a 4 out of 10. There are way better PlayStation games out there and way better Rampage games to play. Pass this up if you see it. Thanks for watching. Goodbye, my friends.